What's up, everybody? Once again, it's BrandMan Sean, and this video is brought to you by BrandManNetwork.com because I signed myself, baby. All right, I got to talk about something that a lot of managers have done. Not every manager, of course, but a lot of managers have done, and maybe some more managers need to be aware of this strategy. Artists, you should be aware of this too. It's just a thing. And what that strategy is essentially is blow one artist up to bring a more sustainable artist some visibility. What do I mean by that? Sometimes you have artists that are, let's just say, more lyrical and in this type of space where it's harder for them to get visibility commercially because just blowing that thing up, they likely don't have that single that'll just take off and cut through. However, you might also have another artist who makes that type of music, more singles-driven music, so it's easier to cut them through. Sometimes people just call them superficial or, oh, they're not really talking about anything, whatever. But the point is, that artist is easier to just break through into the marketplace. So you push that artist first, and once you get that artist to break through, now you have visibility, resources, and credibility, and even a grown network that makes it easier to blow up that other artist. A perfect example would be YB in the Mirror, and I'm not saying he's a super single artist who doesn't talk about anything. I'm not super deep into his catalog. However, YB in the Mirror had that one song that was similar to Tay K's song. I can't remember the name of it. And him blowing up gave the YBN name more credibility. And then you get to bring in an artist like YBN Cordae, who just by nature, the type of music he makes and his style is going to have more sustainable and consistent and reliable income over a longer period of time. Because that's the thing about that type of artist. When you think about the YBN Cordae's, or let's say a Kendrick or a J. Cole, anybody in that sphere side of things, you know, y'all know all the artists, they might not even necessarily be that big. When they find fans, they got fans for life, and it's easier for them to evolve with their fans because they're already speaking with more mature content. Then on the other hand, you got these other artists that's easier to get to break through into the marketplace, but even if they aren't just one-hit wonders, their full career probably has more highs, higher highs actually, and lower lows though. And that's the problem, it's not as consistent. It's like, what have you done for me lately? Daniel Caesar is one of those artists, right? Obviously he has those connections to like Chance's manager and all these other resources that was able to help him blow up. But his type of music, once he's there, once he hits a certain plateau or just level, he's gonna be good for a long time because of the type of music that he makes. He might not ever have a hit as big as a Cardi B or something, but he's gonna be good. So that's just something I want to put out there for managers, right? That's something that you can do if you have multiple artists or if you're just looking to figure out how to make this whole thing shake. Maybe you need to get another artist that'll give you a little bit more of that short-term success to then flip the longer-term artist into things. That's the way people look at it. I know artists, y'all are like, that's how a lot of business people look at it in terms of the industry. But for an artist, the same thing, that same concept, you can apply to yourself like so many other artists have done when it comes to blowing up with one single, right? You have that one song that then leads into the rest of your catalog. So you have that one song that's a hit, but then you make sure the rest of your catalog is a little bit more of that other type of stuff that you really want to have for your career. So then a lot of people come because of this other thing, but then the only people who stay are the ones who are interested in this thing, but it got you the visibility, and now you can continue to build up off of that other thing. That's it. As always, this video is brought to you by BrandManNetwork.com because I signed myself. If you like this video, go hit the like button. If you like it, you might as well share. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.